Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, for God is love. And this is how God showed his love among us. He sent his one and only Son to the world that we might live through him. This is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as an atoning sacrifice for our sins. 1 John 4:7 through 10.
We're very fortunate to have with us today Kenny Adams and his wife Ann Adams from the Fresh Start Church of God in Moore, Oklahoma. And they're here for a very special reason today. Kenny serves on the church service team, which is one of the governing boards of the Church of God in Oklahoma. And Luke is in the process of working toward his ordination, and the first step in that process has to do with licensing, and the church service team just this week has licensed Luke as a minister of the gospel, and so I want to have Kenny come and share in the ceremony. They've just begun going into the local churches to do this, which I think is a great way to make this a very personal thing for us to experience as well. So Kenny, thank you for being here, you and your wife both.
Pastor Williams, it's a great honor and pleasure for me to be here today and to be with you on this great day as we celebrate Luke and his journey and going towards ordination. As you said, I'm the chairman of the church service team, which used to be called the Credentials Board. But just real briefly to talk a little bit about the process and what Luke will be going through. He's already completed one set of body of work, and he has achieved what we call now licensing year one. There's also a licensing year two, and then there's ordination following that. And so he has agreed to follow a body of work that we, as on the team, we monitor that and we go through that with him. So as Pastor Williams said, we just interviewed him this last week. As I'm talking to the members of the church service team, we feel very satisfied that the Lord has called him. He's completed his first body of work. We've looked at that and reviewed it, and we're very pleased in that and what he's done. But the most important thing that we're pleased about is that we do feel God's call on his life. That, you know, that's the most important thing. They can, you know, people can do, they can read books and they can write papers and things like that, but they need to have the call. And Luke has demonstrated that in his life. And so we are very pleased to come and share that with him today. And Luke, I've asked you to come forward with us. I'm going to ask him just a series of questions. But, you know, as we get licensing in the Church of God, and as Luke has achieved this first level, we don't give that lightly. It carries full weight of ministry. And Luke, as you continue on in your ministry and on this program, we'd ask that you use the work that's assigned to you that we'll have you do. Use this experience to grow in the Lord and also to hone your skills and gifts that the Lord has graciously given you. And then today we're also asking the Lord that he will greatly bless you in your ministry that you do currently and that you will do in the years to come, and the people that he will entrust to your care as a pastor or as a shepherd as you look after them. So today, before your church family here, but also before God our Father, we would ask you to answer the following questions with, I will. I promise to keep watch over my own life, seeking to live in a manner pleasing to God and worthy of his calling. I promise to set an example for other believers in speech, in life, in love, in faith, and in purity. I promise to study the scriptures that I may teach what is in accord with sound doctrine and handle God's word correctly to the best of my ability. I promise to proclaim the whole counsel of God from the scriptures without fear and without hesitation. Based on your answers you have given us today, we encourage you to remain faithful to your call. I know that you will, and we ask that God will richly guide you and give you his great peace as you face the things and the work that he has you to do from now and going into the future. I also ask Pastor Williams, would it be okay if some of you from the church would like to come and gather around him as we pray for him? And I want to ask his dad to voice the prayer for him, and then after the prayer, we're going to make a pronouncement for Luke today. So if anyone would like to come forward and gather around Luke.
Let us pray together. Our precious Heavenly Father, it amazes us when we think about how you're the creator of the universe, the founder of the church, your divine being, how that you use human beings like us to serve in your kingdom. And Lord, we thank you so very much today for your call upon Luke's life that came a number of years ago, actually, and for the fact that he's been obedient to that call. His faith and trust are in you to equip him to do as you have called him to do. And Lord, today we gather around him to pray for him. We pray that you help us to be a support to him as the days unfold and years pass. We pray, Lord, that you would also anoint him by the power of the Holy Spirit, that you would fill him with the Spirit to do the work that you've called him to do. Help him first to care for his own soul, his own heart, to be the person that you've called him to be. And we know that when he does that, you'll give him the gifts and the abilities to do just exactly the work then, the ministry that you've called him to do. We pray that you would fill his heart with love for people, love for Jesus, that he would fulfill those two great commandments to love the Lord his God with all of his heart, soul, mind, and strength, and his neighbor as self. And Father, we pray for him as challenges come, for there will be many. Many unexpected things will come his way, and many difficult decisions that he will encounter. And Father, we pray that in all those things, that he will seek your presence, seek your face, seek your will, and bow humbly before you to realize that this is a work that can only be done with your equipment and your power and the Holy Spirit guiding through his life. And so, Lord, we thank you for this day. Continue, Lord, to bless him in his work in ministry, in his own soul, and also in his personal life. To you be the glory. We pray all this in Jesus' blessed name.
Again, thank you for allowing me to be here today, but as a representative of the church service team and also as a representative of the Oklahoma Assembly of the Church of God, we now declare that Luke is a fully licensed minister in the Church of God. Let's give him a round of applause. I'm going to grab a couple of pictures. I'm going to ask Luke and Luke to come up. And
we're going to move along into prayer too for our congregation and continue to pray for Rusty as he continues to heal up and the therapy he's going to be going through with his hip replacement. Also, Betty McGuire is going to be having her gallbladder removed tomorrow, so we'll keep her in your prayers. And Doyle Jackson is hoping to move.